Frugal friends, welcome back. So this morning, as I am wrapping up my regular household chores, dishes, getting the kitchen tidied up, and getting these floors done, I'm also bringing down all of our Christmas and holiday stuff. Everything except for Halloween, which is now out, been relegated out to its new, formerly eBay, but now Halloween shed. So I'm gonna bring all the holiday stuff down. If you're a dumpster diver, you know that you find tons of holiday decorations for every holiday. If you're hitting up the craft stores and the party stores and the dollar store dumpsters, you're finding so much more holiday decorations than you can possibly handle. Well, that's the point that I'm at. And I have gotten rid of some throughout the years and passed those on and donated, and some just had to just plain get rid of because they were just all loved out. But there's so much more. And while I'm taking this time off from bringing more stuff in, this is one of those things I have got to do. So the goal, this is the goal, to get our Christmas stuff. this is going to be big, guys, down to two totes plus the fake tree. We have a fake tree and then two totes. One of those will be everything that goes on the tree. This is not including our lights, because those have their own separate tote because we use lights for other holidays and other things. So not including the twinkle lights, but just the actual decorations, things that go in the house, all right? And then things that go on the tree, and then plus there'll be the tree itself. I wanna get all of that down to two totes. This is a huge, oh my gosh, especially once you see how much stuff we have. And this is after having downsized our Christmas for the last 3 years. Yeah, it's because we're constantly bringing more of it in. And I'll find things that are just so fabulous and I just really want to keep them. And the problem is you run out of space. And after our recent scare, crazy scare with the fire and the gas leak, our main purpose right now, our main priority is decluttering, cleaning out, and addressing safety concerns and issues in our house. Having too much stuff, having it in the wrong places, having it near fire sources, potentially combustible situations, flammable disasters, we're trying to avoid any future calamities, all right, and safeguard ourselves here in our house. So I'm gonna bring all the holiday stuff down. We're gonna start with the Christmas. We're gonna get down to the priorities. We go all out for Halloween, you know this. And so the other holidays, they're all gonna need to take a step back. We do put up a little bit for each holiday, but I'm not gonna go massive anymore. I can't do it. I don't have the room for the stuff. It's just silliness. And though I love putting all of it up, the problem is Easter is only this one short period each year. Same with Christmas, although it gets longer every year, doesn't it? The rest of the year, it just takes up space. It is dead weight in our house. And if you every week, or some of you, oh my goodness, every day are dumpster diving and bringing stuff into process, and you don't have a warehouse or a huge storage unit or a massive home and a big garage, I have none of those things, then it gets overwhelming and it piles up really, really fast. And it gets on top of you, and that should never be the case. And that is what we're fighting against. We're gonna get the Christmas down to the two totes, plus the tree and the lights. All the other holidays, guys, and I have stuff for 4th of July, Easter, Valentine's, St. Patty's Day, general summer, general whatever, general spring. I want to get all of that, every bit of it. Oh my gosh, I'm like, my heart is fluttering and everything's like speeding up. You can hear it in my voice, obviously. Just to even say this out loud, I want to get all of it down to two totes. Two totes of just my favorite things, not just random dollar store crap. The things that we actually always put up. How much stuff do you have sitting in those holiday decoration totes that you rarely even actually put up because you're not in love with it, or it's not worth the effort to put it up, but you hold on to it anyway? No more. We are gonna narrow it down to the things that I always put up every year that we really love, that are sentimental, that mean a lot. That is the idea. With some help from my fabulous Olivia Lulu, we were able to get all of this stuff down. And honestly, guys, it's not nearly as bad as I thought. There's literally 1, 2, 3, 4, five-ish, six, seven, like eight totes and some odds and ends. Like there's, you know, our pillows and blanket that there's no way we're getting rid of. We use these every year here on the couch. Not getting rid of those, but I'm feeling incredibly encouraged. It looks like my efforts over the last few years of downsizing and decluttering have seriously made an impact. Now I'm still sticking to my goal. We're gonna get down to this tote and one other for Christmas. Besides light and tree, and probably besides the pillows and blanket, because they just go like in a big hefty bag. The other holidays, we will also get those down to just two totes. Like I've got a mix of Valentine's and Easter, and I don't know what else in there. So we will go through those. There are some things that need to be repaired, like the Catalan poop log. I think we might keep him. What do you think, Olivia? Will we keep him? Yes, she says yes. She's busy doing homework. That's another thing we're working on today is her projects and assignments. Yeah, there's a few other things, yeah, that probably need to be repaired, and I will work on those. I need to spruce up the wreath for my dad's grave. I like to spruce that up every year. It almost even needs to be started over, but I don't know. I think we can pretty it up. I'm working on the Valentine's things, and I've emptied out the tote, and now I'm going to dump out, you know, the little bits of odds and ends that are in there and just have it tidy. I've got a pile here of things that are like Valentine's, you know, things that we will give away for our Valentine gifts and things like that at school. And those I don't think should go with the Valentine's decorations. They are not decorations. So I'm going to put those with our actual Valentine's. We have a couple of little baskets of Valentine's cards, and we will put those with that. There's a bag here. It just needs a quick stitch to repair this. Some people would just throw that away, and I absolutely could, but I use this bag, and I want to keep it. So it'll just take 2 seconds to stitch that up and repair it. Other than that, there's really not that much. And just by getting those Valentines that don't belong in here out and stacking nicely, this should all fit very nicely into this tote. I already made some tough choices on things that needed to go bye-bye that were just absolutely worn out and beyond repair that I've just held on to for no good reason, and things that could be recycled and needed to be recycled. So those are gone. So now let's see if we can restack all this. And as I'm doing that, I will be, you know, thinking things over with each item and deciding if that is something that I really do want to hold on to. The Valentine's Day tote is done. I just need to put the lid on and it can go back up into the attic. This tote is an assortment. It has St. Patty's Day. It has a little bit of Easter that needs to go in the Easter tote. It's even got some Christmas stuff that got thrown in. It's got 4th of July. Oh boy. Okay, so I'm just gonna start just like I did with the Valentine's tote, and I'm just gonna start taking the stuff out and we'll make some tough choices. Though there's really not much here, I don't think there's gonna be many things that we do need to get rid of. Mostly I think it's just gonna be, you know, getting it organized. St. Patrick's Day things are coming along nicely. I used some of my zippy bags that I reuse over and over and over to organize some of these things. I have a few more that need to be done. I've just got to grab another couple of zippy bags. The big shamrock needed to be repaired, so I have put glue on it and I'm waiting for that to dry. This is going to be so incredibly organized. It's going to make a lot more sense. And now that I'm putting all this effort in, it really is just a matter of sticking with it, you know, when those holidays actually come up and I do the decorating and then take it all down. Yeah, that's going to be the real challenge, guys. I mean, this is a ton of work, but the real test is after those holidays, getting everything put back in this same organized fashion. This tote is just about ready. I've got all of the 4th of July stuff. There really was not that much. I got all that in there and in its own little box. So I'm just waiting on that shamrock to finish drying. And then this tote just needs its lid and can go right back up into the attic. Now we will start working on the Easter stuff. Now, keep in mind, I have to remind myself, I had a goal of getting down to just two totes. Well, so far it's looking like three is where we're going to end up. But no, I am determined. We are going to somehow get it down to two totes.
I don't know how, but we're gonna make it happen. So again, gonna just start sorting it all out and gonna make some tough choices. The majority of what was in here was actually just plastic eggs and plastic grass. So I got rid of a bunch of that, and now I'm going to get all of our Easter baskets and then these ones that I use to put like plants in during Easter, all of that and the eggs that I've kept and the grass that I've kept into this tote. And then what I want to do is see if I can take the stuff from the 4th of July and St. Patrick's Day and get all of them except the pillows into this tote.
Frugal friends, oh, I am thrilled to announce I did it. So we have 4th of July, we have St. Patrick's Day, and we have Easter. The only things not going there are the pillows that are for St. Patrick's Day. I gotta clean off some of this sparkly stuff. But anyways, they will just go in a bag, same as I do with the Christmas ones. And I will just have a section, an area where all those bags of pillows are, and they will be clearly marked. But we did it. We got all of the other holidays besides Christmas and Halloween into two totes. I am so proud. Oh my gosh, I am so proud. Now to take a short break, drink some coffee, and then jump into the Christmas stuff. Oh my goodness. I'm going to just tell you straight up. I'm overwhelmed with the Christmas part of it. It's very daunting. I'm going to make some tough choices, but it's going to get done. Thank you so much for joining me for this little adventure and supporting me along the way. You guys are amazing. You're wonderful. Thank you again for letting me have, with your support, this time off to get caught up and organized and sorted out and decluttered. I appreciate it. And I hope you guys are taking time to do those same things that you need to do for yourself, especially if you are a dumpster diver that's consistently bringing things in. Please, please take that time, take those breaks to get everything in order. Holding on to stuff just for the sole purpose of keeping it out of the dumpsters, out of the landfill, it's not a good enough purpose anymore, guys. You got to actually be doing stuff with it and not letting it just take over your life and your home. Because if you do, you're not helping anyone. Not yourself, not your family, not society, and not the environment. All right, on to practice what I preach. We'll see you all real soon.